at 9 to 10, that is I mean that this is the timing for the India. 9 to 10 basically means I think 6:30 to 7:30 as per UAE. Will you be comfortable doing class at that time, Ahmad?
Yeah, okay, sir. But like before, it was good 4:30 to 5:30. That was okay.
30 to 5:30, that means I'll have to schedule my classes at 7 o'clock, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And but there is one problem actually. We have one student, Samiksha is not attending the class these days. She's on vacation and she is having some problem at 7 o'clock. So therefore I won't be able to schedule my classes at 7, but if you can manage at 9:30, that is at around 6:30 to 7:30, that will be great.
No, okay, sir. If it is not possible that time, then 6:30 to 7:30, like for a few days or weeks, we can handle it, no problem.
Okay, so I'll ask my team to schedule my classes for accounts at 9:30 to 6, that is 6:30 to 7:30, and we will schedule our classes of economics after that.
Sir. No problem, sir. Sir, if any time also, but like okay, for 6:30 to 7:30, there's no problem. Thank you,
All right, let's start.
sir.
Let's start today's session. Okay. So in the last class, we have talked about the bill sent for collection, and we have done few questions based on it. We will be proceeding further from the same topic. We will be doing few more questions based on the same concept. Then we will start the new concept, which is called dishonor of bill of exchange. So first of all, let's just revise everything. As far as the general entry for the bill sent for collection is concerned, I have told you that in the book of the drawer, we will be entering these general entries: bill sent to collection account, debit to bills receivable account, then also bank account, debit to bills sent to collection account. This is the general entry in the book of the drawer. But there is no special entry required for the bill sent to bank for collection in the book of the drawing. There will be no entry for this particular activity in the book of the drawing. And we have done this question in the class. And after this, we have also, I think we have also completed this question here only. Yes.
Yes,
And
sir.
I think I gave you this question as homework, right?
Yes, sir, you gave this question.
So we have done this question in the class.
No, sir, we didn't.
I gave you as homework, right? Okay, let's start with this question only. So first of all, just tell me whether you have done this question or not. Halima, Peer, and Hamad, you guys have completed this question, or shall we do this now?
Sir, there is some problems in between. You can discuss until now.
There is some problem with the in between the question.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So first of all, okay, let's do one thing. Let's do this question here only. Halima, you have done this question? Peer, you did this question? No response from anyone. Guys, please tell me. Please let me know, Halima and Peer, whether you have completed this question or not. All right. I'm presuming that none of you have completed this question, so I'll be doing this question. So in this question, Ashok draws on bridge three bills of exchange for rupees 5,000, 4,000, 3,000 respectively for goods sold to him on 1st February 2017. These bills were 1 month, 2 month, and 3 months respectively. The first bill was endorsed to his creditor Chand. The second bill was discounted with his bank on 4th February 2017 at the rate of 12% discount, and the third bill was sent to his bank for collection on 30th of April. On the due date, all the bills were duly met by Bridge. Bank sent the collection advice for the third bill after deducting 25 as collection charges, past the general entry in the book of the Ashok. Okay, so let's solve this question. Just a minute. Okay, so we will be first of all passing the general entry in the book of the Ashok. So first of all, we will be putting the heading in the book of Ashok. in the book of Ashok? Ashok is who? Ashok is a drawer. Ashok is drawer of the bill. Okay. So first of all, we will have to generalize the transaction for the drawing of bill. So Bridge have basically issued three bills valuing 5,000, 4,000, 3,000 first February 2017. So let's generalize this transaction. On 1st of February 2017, general entry will be bills receivable number one, account debit for rupees 5,000. Then bills receivable second, account debit 4,000. Bills receivable again, bills receivable for the third bill, account debit 3,000. Two, Bridge. Bridge account. And the value, sum total of all the bill will be 5,4 + 3. 12,000. Tell me, guys, is this clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
The general entry for the first transaction, that is for the drawing of the bill. Okay. Now, what is he doing with all these bills? This is also given in the question. These bills were for 1 month, 2 months, and 3 months, okay, respectively. The first bill was endorsed to his creditor Chand. All right. So can anyone of you tell me what will be the general entry for the endorsement of bill? Halima, can you tell me the general entry for the endorsement of the bill? The first bill has been endorsed to the creditor of a show. So the general entry for this will be what? No response. Samad, will you be able to answer this?
Sorry, sir.
Will you be able to answer the entry for the, tell me the entry for the endorsement of bill? What is the general entry for the endorsement of bill?
Sir, it will be sold goods for cash.
Good for cash. Why we will be generalizing this? We are endorsing the bill to one of our creditor. Let's say we are endorsing it on the same date. So general entry for the endorsement will be, as I told you, general entry will be creditor account debit, right? Creditor account debit, yes, to VR. This is the general entry for the endorsement. This time creditor, the name of creditor is Chand. So we will be writing Chand account debit to bills receivable. Which bill has been endorsed to Chand? Ahmad, which bill we have endorsed to Chand? The first bill, right?
Bill
first will be debt credited. The value of the first bill was
5,000.
Is this okay? Is this correct, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, let's talk about the second bill. The second bill was discounted with his bank on 4th of February on the same date. In the same month, bill has been discounted with the bank. All right, and this bill has a due date of how many months? 2 months. So second bill have the due date of 2 months. This has been discounted with the bank at the rate 12% per annum. All right. So let's generalize this transaction. What is the general entry for the discounting of bill? For the discounting of bill. Anyone? Halima? What is the general entry for the discounting of bill? Tell me. It is very simple. Bank account will be debited. Right? Discounting charges account will be debited. Correct? Amar?
Yes.
And discounting charge account debit. After this, tell me. Two. Bills receivable account, right? This is the general entry in the book of the drawer. So bank account will be credited by how much? First of all, tell me which bill has been endorsed to which bill has been discounted with the bank? The second bill. So bills receivable second will be credited. The amount of the second bill is how much?
4,000.
Okay. But bank is charging discount, bank will be applying the discounting charge. Discounting charge is how much? 12% per annum. All right. So 12% per annum will be how much? Any idea? 12% per annum will be how much? Someone please tell me. 12% discounting charge we will apply. For 2 months?
Sir, 800.
800. Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
I don't think so. It will be 800. Let's just calculate. Discounting charge. Let me calculate it here. We will be charging discounting on 4,000 at the rate 12%, right?
Yes, sir. And then 2 by
period 12. Is how many, for how many period?
We 2 months.
2 months. 2 upon 12.
Yes, sir.
All right. So just calculate it. Let me calculate it.
Sorry, sir. 80, sir. 80.
It will be 80, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You are sure this time?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So it will be 80. So discounting charge will be 80. So the remaining amount will be debited to the bank account. So remaining amount will be how much? 3920.
Yes, sir.
Is this correct? Hamad, is this correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, now let's talk about the next bill on 30th April. Okay, and the third bill was sent to his bank for collection of 30th April. So the third bill has been sent to bank for collection. All right. So on 30th April, we are sending it for collection. 30th April. On 30th April, the general entry for this transaction will be. Tell me the general entry for this.
Sir, bill sent to collection account debit.
Correct. Bill sent to collection or bill sent for collection. You can write this as well. Bill sent for collection account debit. Account will be debited. Two, tell me. Bills receivable account. Which bill has been sent for collection?
Sir, third.
And the value of the third bill is how much? 3,000. Sir, will be debited. 3,000 will be credited. Done. And finally, on the due date, we will be receiving money. What will be the due date of this bill? Due date will be, January and February, March, April, May. Okay, so on 4th May, we will be receiving money. Right?
Yes, sir, he will receive money after 3 months.
Yes, after the period of 3 months. Okay, let's just for the time being, just skip this part. So this is the general entry for the bill sent for collection on 30th April. Bill sent for collection, account debit 3000 to bill receivable. Is this clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now on the due dates, all the bills were duly met by Bridge. All the bills are duly met by Bridge. The bank sent the collection advisors for the third bill after deducting 25 as collection charges. That means on the third bill, bank will be imposing collection charge. As I told you, on if bank is collecting the bank bill on behalf of you, then bank will impose some charge, which is called collection charge or the bank charge. Okay. So all the bill will be met on the due date. So we will have to generalize the transaction for all the bills on the due date. So what will be the general entry on the due date? On May 4, we will be collecting the payment for how many bills?
Three bills.
Three bills? Are you sure? We will be receiving the payment for how many bills? Three bills, two bills, or one bill?
Sir, after 3 months.
Yes, after 3 months, we will be receiving the payment for how many bills?
Three bills.
Are you sure, Hamad? How many bills? We will be receiving the payment for how many bills on 4th May? Tell me.
Three bills, sir.
Not three bills.
Sir, one bill.
4th May 2017.
Will it receive the third bill?
We will receive the payment for the third bill only, no?
Yes, sir.
See, why so?
Because
the bill have been basically endorsed to Chand. So Chand will be receiving the payment for this. Is this correct?
Yes,
sir.
Second bill has been endorsed to bank. Sorry, we have already discounted.
Sent to collection.
Payment for the second bill. So on the due date, the payment will be collected by the bank only. And finally, on the third bank, on the third bill, that third bill we have sent it to the bank for collection. That means on the due date, we will be receiving the payment for only one bill. Now tell me, when this bill, the due date will arise, what will be the general entry? What will be the general entry when the due date will arrive? So it is very simple. First of all, we will write down bank account debited. On due date, bank account will be debited. Is this correct, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Bank account will be debited.
Sir, we can also write cash account debited.
You can also write cash account, but it is generally presumed that if you have sent the bank bill for collection to bank, so bank will be crediting your account amount in your bank account. Therefore, bank account will be credited. Sorry, debited. But bank will be imposing some discounting some collection charges, right? So collection charge will also be debited, because collection charge is an expense. So collection charge will be debited again. Ahmad, is this clear?
Yes, it's clear.
Collection charge account will also be debited. And now
to the third person
for collection. You are not required to write down bills receivable third. We have already credited it earlier. So now we will be crediting this bill sent for collection. Bills sent for collection account. Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So bill sent for collection will be the price, the value of it was how much? 3000.
Yes, sir.
And bank account will be credited by how much? Tell me.
Sir, minus 25.
Minus?
25. Sir, it was.
Yes, correct. So, just a minute. So, 25 will be collection charges and only 2975 will be debited. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Got it? Is this clear, everyone? So, these are the various general entries in the book of the drawer only. Now, let's talk about the drawee. It is very simple. There is no much transaction in the book of the drawee. So first of all, we will be writing in the book of the drawee. The name of drawee is what? Name of drawee is Bridge. Okay. So first of all, we will be generalizing the activity of the acceptance given. So what will be the journal entry here? Tell me. Ashok account will be debited, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Two. How many bills have been issued? Three bills. So we will be writing bills. Payable account. Two bills payable account second. Two bills payable account third. The value will be 5,000, 4,000,
3,000.
Correct? And this will be 12,000. Is this correct, Hamad?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, he will be entering this journal entry will be done on the 1st of February, right? 1st of February. Now, finally, on the due date, that is 4th of May 2017. No, not on the 4th of May. First of all, he will...
Sir, for the first bill?
Yeah, first bill has been drawn for only 1 month, no? So the first entry will be done for the payment on the 4th of March, right? 4th March 2017. Yes or no? The first bill has been drawn only for 1 month. So the payment of the first bill will be done on the 4th of March. For that, yes, he will be writing the journal entry like, tell me, what will be the journal entry in this case? First bill has been endorsed to Z, no?
Yes, Z account debit.
Not Z account debit. We will be debiting our bills payable account. Bills payable account will be debited. Bills payable account will be debited. Tell me. Our bank account will reduce, no? Or cash account will reduce either.
Yes.
And write bank account debited. So the value of the first bill was how much? 5,000. So 5,000 on the 4th of March will be paid. This is the general entry for the payment of bill. Is this correct? Hamad, is this clear? Halima, is this clear? Halima is not responding today. Okay, next bill will be due on 4th of April. Right?
Yes, so, sir.
For this bill, he will be writing again. This was a bills payable first. So on the 4th.
Sir, the same entry is for the second and third also.
Second bill as well. Same entry will be done. Bills payable account debit for the second bill to bank account. Then 4,000 and 4,000. Is this clear, Hamad?
Yes, it's clear.
And for the third bill, which will be due on 4th of May, 4th May 2017, general entry will be bills payable third account debit. The value of it was 3,000 to bank account 3,000. Is this clear, Peer? Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is it. So we have completed books of both the drawer and the drawee. Okay, so now let's do one more question based on the similar concept so that you can understand the concept in a better way. On January 15, 2017, Kusum sold goods for ₹30,000 to Pushpa and drew upon her three bills of exchanges of ₹10,000 each, payable after 1 month, 2 months, and 3 months, respectively. The first bill was retained by Kusum till its maturity. The second bill was endorsed by her in favor of her creditor, Khushbu, and the third bill was discounted by her immediately at the rate 6% per annum. All the bills were met by the Pushpa generalize the above transaction in the book of the Kusum and Pushpa. Come on, everyone. Do it. And I expect that you can finish this question within 10 minutes. And if you have any difficulty or you won't be able to solve this within the 10 minutes, then I'll be solving it. All right, Hamad and Peer and Halima. Guys?
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay, try this question. I'm here only. I'm just muting myself and turning off my camera. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. I'll unmute me and unmute myself and answer your doubt. Let me know, everyone, if you have any doubt or when you are done solving this question. Peer, Hamad, and Halima.
Okay.
Also, tell me if you're having any problem.
Done, sir. Sir, you're muted.
All right, done. Peer, you have completed this question?
Sir, last transaction. Sir.
Last one. Okay. Last one in the book of Pushpa or Kusum?
Sir, Pushpa.
Pushpa. Okay. Done, Peer. Do it faster, come on. Ahmad, do you have doubt? Any doubt in the question?
No, sir, I don't have any doubt.
Okay, we will wait a little more. For you to finish, then we will continue.
Okay.
Peer, what happened, Peer? Why are you taking so long? Peer is not here. Already left the session. Okay, anyways, let's start. Let me show you the correct answer of the question. And I want you to please compare your solution with the solution I'm showing you. Hamad?
Okay.
Okay, so this is the solution. So first entry we will pass the for the sale of goods, right? Pushpa to sales account, 30,000, 30,000, right? Then
yes, sir.
You have done this. No, you have done the same transaction. Then we will receive three bills. Kusum will receive three bills. Bills receivable account debit first. Bills receivable second account debit. Bills receivable account third debit to Pushpa account. Done. And for the third, then bill has been endorsed to Khushbu. So for this, general entry will be Khushbu account debit to bills receivable account second. And the third bill has been discounted with the bank. So bank account debit, discount account, discounting charge account debit to bills receivable account. Discounting charge, you have calculated how much, Ahmad? Is this correct? 150 is your answer?
Yes, it's correct.
Very good. Next is finally the third bill has been kept. The first bill has been kept by the drawer. Therefore, the on the due date, the payment of only one bill will be received by the Kusum cash account debit to bills receivable account first. Okay. Now moving on to the Pushpa book. So Pushpa will write down the general entry for the purchase of goods, purchase account debit to Kusum. Then for the issuing of bill, Kusum account debit to bills payable, bills payable, bills payable, first, second, and third. And on the due date, the first bill will get the due date on the 18th of February, because first bill has been drawn for only 1 month period. So bills payable account debit to cash. And in the next month, March 18, bills payable account debit to cash again. And for the third bill, in the 18th of April, general entry will be bills payable account debit to cash again. Is this correct? Any doubt, Hamad?
No, sir, no doubt.
No doubt. Okay. Halima, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Why are you not responding today?
I'm not well, sir, today.
You're not well. Okay. So, guys, we are about to start a new concept, which is known as dishonor of bills of exchange. So anyone of you have any idea what is dishonor of bill? Anyone having any idea what is actually dishonor of bill?
Sir, can I explain it in my own words?
Yeah, sure.
Please, sir, like when that drawer, he made a bill and like on some like example for tomorrow, he made a bill on tomorrow he can go and collect the money from bank, and he does not collect the money, so it's known as like for maturity, like that. Something.
Yeah. Basically, bill is a bill which is drawn by the drawee or the drawer. On the due date, if the payment is not made by the drawee on the due date, that is called the dishonor of bill. All right.
Yes.
Let's say I have drawn a bill upon you, on Hamad, for ₹10,000, and Hamad is basically promising me to pay the bill after the period of 2 months. So I retained the bill for the period of 2 months. I have waited for the due date to arrive. Then I have presented this bill to Hamad and ask him to make the payment, right? But he makes a default in payment. He denied making payment. So this is called the dishonor of bill. When bill is not paid on the due date, this is called dishonor of bill. All right. So, yeah. When bill get dishonored, we basically go to the, what do we call him? Notary. Notary is a government office. We go to notary, inform notary about the dishonor of bill, get it noted with the notary, and notary will charge some noting charges. All right, basically, noting is done with the notary with the purpose of as a proof that bill has been dishonored by the Hamad. Hamad is not making payment. So I went to the government office, which is called notary. I get it registered with the notary, informing the notary that I have presented the bill to Hamad and Hamad is not making payment of the bill. This is called dishonor of bill. In case of dishonor, we present the bill in the notary and get it registered with the notary. And registration with the notary is basically for the evidence purpose. that I have presented the instrument, but Hamad have not made the payment, and because I can justify my point later, therefore I have registered it with the notary public, that is with the government office. All right, is this clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
So notary public will charge certain amount. This is called noting charges. They are not going to register the dishonor without any charge. They will be charging certain amount that will be called noting charges. All right, that noting charges will be eventually paid by the drawee. Right now, when I'll be noting it down with the notary, I'll have to make the payment, but eventually, ultimately, this is a liability upon the drawee. All right. So let's read the definition of the dishonor. Dishonor of bill means that the drawee of the bill of exchange on the due on the date of maturity is not able to make the payment for the bill. In such a situation, the holder of the bill can then recover the amount from the drawer on any other or any other previous endorser. So for the time being, just ignore this part or any other previous endorser. Just keep this in mind that in case of dishonor of the bill, drawer is not able to recover the amount from the drawee. That means drawee will still be liable to make the payment. Okay, so just keep this in mind. Basically, dishonor of bill is something. It is basically a situation wherein the drawee have defaulted in making the payment of the bill. Okay. Now, let's talk about the general entry when the bill is. Let's now talk about the general entry when bill get dishonored. And let me correct this. I have a mistake. I have written. It is not bill sent for collection. Bill when bill gets dishonored and bill is dishonored. Okay, when bill is dishonored. So when bill get dishonored, we will have to generalize this activity, right? We will have to generalize it in the book of the drawer as well as in the book of the drawee. Is this correct, everyone? When the bill gets dishonored, we will have to generalize this activity. So in the book of the drawer, general entry will be done. But general entry depends upon certain situations. Because there is a situation, there may be a case one that bill is retained by the drawer till the maturity date and then it gets dishonored. This is situation number one. That bill which gets dishonored, it was actually retained by the drawer till the maturity date, and when drawer presented it for the payment, it gets dishonored. This is situation number one. And in such a situation, the general entry will be drawee account debit to bill's receivable account. Like for example, if Hamad have issued me a bill of exchange and Hamad is later on, he's denying to make the payment, then I will be generalizing the transaction as Hamad account debit to bill's receivable account. Simple. But in the book of the drawee, what will be the general entry in the book of the drawee, general entry will be bill's payable account debit to noting charges to drawer. That basically means that drawee will have to make the payment for the bills payable. Number one, let's say if Hamad have issued the bill of rupees 10,000, so he will have to make the payment for the first of all 10,000 rupees, and he will also have to pay the noting charges, right? And also he will have to make the payment for only noting charges and the amount of bill he will have to make payment to the drawer. So this will be the general entry in the book of the drawee. Is this clear, everyone? So first case will be when bill is retained by the drawer till the maturity date and it get dishonored on due date. Is this clear? That on the due date, the sorry on
yes, sir.
getting the bill, if the bill get dishonored, the general entry will be drawee account debit to bills receivable. On the other hand, drawee will get again, he will get liable towards the drawer. Now the liability of the drawee towards the drawer will be how much? The amount of bill payable, number one, and the noting charges as well. So this time he will be debiting the bills payable account, noting charges account to drawer's account. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Situation number one, when bill is dishonored after it is retained by the drawer himself. Now there is a possibility that drawer must have basically discounted it with the bank, right? And after discounting it with the bank, you know, who will be presenting it for the payment? When the drawer have discounted the bill with the bank, on the due date, who will be presenting the bill of exchange to the drawee? The drawer will be presenting it to the drawee for the payment, or the bank will be presenting it to the drawee for the payment? Tell me. If bill has already been discounted with the bank, then on the due date, who will be presenting the instrument to the drawee for the payment? Tell me. Ahmad, Peer.
The drawee.
Drawer will present it again. You know the meaning of discounting, no?
Yes.
In case of discounting, we sell our bill of exchange to the bank. So on the due date, now bank will be presenting the bill of exchange to the drawee for the payment, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. And now when it is presented to the drawee on the due date, bank come to know that drawee is not making payment. Drawee have made the default on the due date. Is it clear? So on the due date, when bill get dishonored in such a situation, the general entry will be drawee account debit to bank account. Is this clear? Drawee account debit to bank account. We will be generalizing this transaction. Drawee account debit to bank account. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Remember this now. Drawee account debit to bank account. So in our case, like the example I have taken, so I'll be writing the name of the Hamad account debit to bank account. This will be the general entry if it get dishonored after getting it discounted with the bank. And no new general entry will be in the book of the drawee. Drawee will be making the same general entry. Bills payable account debit, noting charges account debit to drawer. Same entry will be done in the book of the drawee in case of bill getting dishonored. Now, situation number third can be this, that and the bill has been endorsed to some person and now it is getting dishonored. After endorsement of bill is getting dishonored on the due date. So in that case, the general entry will be drawee's account debit to endorsee account. See, in every general entry, common thing is that we will be debiting the drawee account. See, in the earlier transaction as well, see, in the first general entry as well, we have debited the drawee account. In the second journal entry, we have debited the drawing account again. And for the third transaction also, we are debiting the drawee account only. Is this clear? If the bill is dishonored after discounting, we will be writing drawee account debit to bank. If it is getting dishonored after endorsing, so we will be writing drawee account debit to endorsee account. So that means that if I have basically endorsed my bill of exchange to peer, so I'll be writing Hamad account debit to peer account. And in the book of the drawee, same transaction will be done. Same general entry will be done. Bills payable account debit, noting charges account debit to drawer account. Same. Now finally, bill is getting dishonored, which was sent to bank for collection. Now we come to know that particular bill is getting dishonored. In that case, any guesses what will be the general entry, Hamad? When bill get dishonored after sending it to bank for collection, what will be the general entry?
Sir, drawee account debit.
Drawee account debit, correct? to bank account.
To bank bill sent to bank for collection.
Correct. Drawee account debit to bill sent for collection. This is it. And will there be any new general entry in the book of the drawee?
No.
No, the same general entry. Bills payable account debit, noting charges account debit to drawer account. Clear, everyone? Will you be able to remember this? All of the general entries?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so guys, okay, let's do one thing. Let's do one question today. Then we will be solving few more questions based on the dishonorable bill in the next class. So let's start. Let's do this question only. This is a very simple question. We will be able to solve this within a few minutes. So just read this. Ram draws a bill for ₹2,000 on Shyam on 15th of September 2018 for 3 months, right? On maturity, Shyam failed to honor the bill, pass the necessary journal entry in the book of the Ram and Shyam. So we have to journalize the transaction in the book of the Ram as well as in the book of Shyam. So first of all, we are starting from the book of the Ram. Is question clear, everyone? What is happening in the question? Ram have drawn a bill on Shyam for ₹2,000 for how many period? 3 month period, right? And after the 3 month, bill is getting honored or dishonored? Tell me. Peer, Halima and Hamad, Steve, bill is getting honored after the due date or it is getting dishonored?
Getting dishonored.
It is honored.
It will be dishonored.
Honored the bill, that means it is getting dishonored. So we will first of all generalizing the transaction in whose book? Tell me, in whose book we will be generalizing transaction for the first
Ram.
So this will be the general entry in the book of Ram. Try to pay attention here. See, this will be the general entry. First of all, we will be generalizing it as bills receivable account debit to Shyam account, right? This will be for the acceptance of bill. Correct? Bills receivable account debit to Shyam account. Is this correct, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Hamad and Ali. Okay. Now, finally, on the due date, we will be generalizing the transaction for the dishonor of bill. Because this bill is not sent to bank for collection, neither it has been discounted, neither it has been endorsed to some person. This means that the drawer have himself kept this bill with himself, right? So on the due date, we will be writing the general entry on account of getting it dishonored. We will be writing Shyam account debit to bills receivable account. As I told you, drawee's account debit to bills receivable account. See, here I have told you, if the bill is kept with the drawer till the date of maturity and then it get dishonored, the general entry will be drawee account debit to bills receivable account. Correct? That is what we are doing in the question. See, in the question, we are writing bills, Shyam account debit to bills receivable account. Shyam is who? Shyam is our drawee. Is this correct, Halima? Peer and Steve, Hamal?
Sir, what about notice?
Noting charges?
Yes, sir.
Noting charge. There is no information regarding the noting charge in the question. Is there any information regarding the noting charges?
No, sir.
Had been there, we would have been recorded it.
Okay.
Done, everyone? Understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's talk about the book of Shyam. So Shyam will be generalizing the transaction for the issuance of the bill, for the drawing of the bill. So he will be writing down Ram account debit to bills payable account. Is this correct, everyone?
Yes, sir.
And finally, when bill get dishonored, what will be the general entry? Bills payable account debit, noting charges account debit to Ram account, to drawer's account. But since there is no noting charges, therefore, bills payable account debit to Ram account only. Is this correct, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Done. This is it. So, general entry for the dishonor is also very, very simple.
Sir, notice charge, it will be debited or credited?
Noting charges.
Noting charges will be debited or credited.
Noting charges will be debited because it is an expense for the drawee.
Okay.
So if it is given in the question, it would be debited here. All right, everyone?
Sir, for Ram account?
even for RAM account, no, it will be, in that case, it will be credit. First of all, in case of RAM account, the noting charges are already included in the value of the bills receivable. So we will be solving the question. Don't worry about that. When any question will be having some noting charges, you will be able to understand it more in a more better way. So right now, just not discuss about noting charges. We will be discussing about that later. Is this clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So guys, you want this PowerPoint or you are taking the screenshot of the everything that I am teaching you?
Screenshot.
I can share it with you.
Yes,
I can share it with you. Anyone want this?
Yes, sir, you can share it.
Yes, sir, share, sir.
Okay, so I'll be sharing it through Nishkarsh. You will be getting it probably tomorrow. Okay?
Okay,
guys, thank you for taking class today. And we will be talking more about bill of exchange in tomorrow's session. We will be doing more questions based on the dishonor of bill. And probably we will start a new concept in the bill of exchange only. We will be talking about the renewal of bill. And that is going to be the last topic of this particular chapter. So this is it for today's class. Thank you everyone for taking the class. I'll be sharing this PowerPoint. Make sure you revise everything before you attend the next class. Thank you, guys.
Okay, sir. Thank you.